Springfield Mall. So this is our website, bigdatahandson.com. So here, you know, in this homepage, at our homepage, you know, like we have the yesterday's videos would be here. So this is part 5. Yesterday's video is part 5. And today's video, you know, it would be part 6. So it would be uploaded here in the homepage. So you can just click on it and you can see the whole session. And if you want, you know, like you can just go to Meetup uploads and Meetup videos. And you can see all other sessions, no? Like here you can see all other sessions, like part 5, part 4, part 3, everything, all you can see here. And if you are clicking this, no? Like from part 1, part 2, part 3, part 4, part 5, all you can see here. So you can... you can see using these, these sessions, the older sessions, no, you can see. If you have any doubts, you know, like you can just, you can call us, here, or you have the thing like 978-988-424 or else 9566182384. Like you can call any of the numbers, or you can just make a WhatsApp to any of these numbers. If you have any doubts, no, you can call us directly, or any queries, no, you can call us directly. And today, today's topic, no, which we are going to see, Irfan, we are going to go with polymorphism, right?
It's inheritance and polymorphism.
Okay, we are going to see inheritance and polymorphism. So it's it will come under OOPS concept. So these parts, no, would be covered. But today I have not included inheritance here. So we'll be having inheritance as well. So this is the agenda which we are going to cover. Along with this, you know, like we will be going to, we are going to cover inheritance as well. So, we shall go with inheritance. And tomorrow we are going to cover, tomorrow what would be the topic, Irfan? It would be Django, right?
Django, yeah.
Yeah, tomorrow it will be like Python Django. It's a framework. So, from tomorrow our Python session ends. Then we will go with machine learning sessions. And that would be subsequent, that would be, I will inform you tomorrow when we are going to go with machine learning sessions. Thank you. Now, Irfan, you can continue with Python sessions.
Okay.
And so let me just unshare the screen. And Irfan, you can continue with sharing your screen.
Yeah. Can you see my screen?
Yes. Yes, we are able to see the screen. Guys, any doubts, please ask, please put in your chat, which is there. So you can, so we'll make sure that all your questions and queries is answered in the, in the end of the session. Please make sure that you have a chat option there. Put your queries in the chat option. Thank you.
First, we will see inheritance. So what is inheritance means? You can have a capability to derive a class from another class. Okay, let's say you have a developing an application. So you need to update the application. What you did? You need to write another program? No, just take all the programs you write and update with using another class. So derive another class. So you can just update your application. So let's see an example. Let's take class A here. So let's say class A contains greed. Say good morning. So this is our class content. So it contains greed, which needs to be self, because non-static method first keyword should be self. And, let's create an object for that. So how you call the function? obj.grade. Okay, this works. So it's working. So I don't want good morning like that. So I want something more. So what I get? I will create another class. I will not change this class anymore. So I will create another class here. Let's say B. So B is inheriting A. Okay. How you can inherit? Just put parentheses here. In that parentheses, just give what class you need to from derive that class. Okay. So I'm deriving class B from class A. Okay. Now, the class A becomes super class of B, and the B is subclass of A. Okay. Let's create another function. New grid. I'm going to create an object for B. Okay. Now the power of inheritance, it is, you can use the greed function also. That is inside a super class. So how you can use inheritance? So you can use the functions and the attributes in that super class also, and also you can use the functions and the attributes inside the subclass also. You can see here greed function also is available, and a new greed also available. So greed is under the class A and new greed under the class B. So if I create class B object, it contains two things. So it contains a class A properties and the class B properties. Okay. So like morning one is coming. In Python we have four types of inheritance. So one is single level inheritance. So this is an example for single level inheritance. So one super class and one subclass, that is a single level inheritance. So let's see, let's put I'm going to create another class here. Let's name it as C. C inherits B. So what is the super class of C? Super class of C is B, and the super class of B is A. So this is something like chain reaction. So that is called multi-level inheritance. Okay. When you have these two class only, that is single level inheritance. When you have three class, that is a multi-level inheritance. So if I create the object for C, you can see it contains the three class of properties. You can see here the three properties available from three classes. You can use any of these. This inheritance is called multi-level inheritance. So clear? Now let's say I'm not inheriting B to A. Say, okay. If I create a object for C, it only contains B property and C property, okay? Because the superclass of C is B, so we don't have the superclass of B is not B. So I want A class also, A class property also, without inheriting the B object, B class. So how you can get the? You can just put another class here also inside this. So you can also have two classes or three classes, anything we have. So this inheritance is called multiple inheritance. So one class and multiple super class. So what is the super class of C? That is A and B. Okay. So I create the object of C contains three properties. If I create B object, will only contain that property only. Okay, so it's containing only one. So now if I create C object, it will contain three properties. Now it is containing three properties. Okay. Let's say I am having this name, so grid itself. So here also grid, here also grid. What happened if I create a C object? So let's see. Here. So remove this. So it's containing only two properties. It's because the same name is available here, so that is why we are getting only one property. So if I call grid here, which function will call, this function or this function? Let's see. So now it is calling good morning, that is some class A. Why it's calling the class is because which super class is available on first here, inherits first, that class only is called. Okay, if I inherit first here B, if I inherit B here first and after that inherit A, the grid will call the class B grid will call. Let's see that. Okay. So this is called a multiple inheritance, and the last one, it is hierarchical inheritance. So hierarchical inheritance means you have two inheritance together, that is hierarchical inheritance. Let's say I'm having this is multiple inheritance, and one more I have, say class D here. Class D inherits A. So that's become single level now. So this becomes single level, and this three becomes multiple. So that is called a hierarchical inheritance. If I create object of D, it contains two properties. One is the D function and another one is the grid function. If I create C object, it contains sample and grid. So it's because the two name is same, no? That's why, because we will get only one property. that property should be the first inherited class. Okay. I hope that understand you. Okay. Now let's move on to the polymorphism. So what is polymorphism means? Poly means many and morph means form. So one thing that have many forms, that is polymorphism. In that polymorphism, we have
duck type. Duck type, not that duck type.
And another one is method overloading. And another one is method overriding.
Overloading. Overloading.
And the last one is operator overloading.
Overloading.
Okay. First we will see the duck typing. What is duck typing means? Let's create a class here. Class have like IDLE here. I'm creating a class IDLE. And now I'm going to create a constructor
here.
Next we don't want the constructor. Run.
Please go on mute. Someone is talking. Ar Rahman or another person. Abdul Rahim, please go on mute. Someone, now it's fine. Okay, Irfan, you can continue, Irfan.
That IDLE contains a method called run. So like this, if I click on run, it will run the program. So like that, so we have run. It takes some IDLE. So in that IDLE, I will execute. IDLE dot execute. So how to create the IDLE object? It's an IDLE object. First we need to create an IDLE. Let's create an IDLE of a spider, let's say. In that spider, we have a method called execute. So that the execute function like contain like compiling program. And running. Let's say I have this IDLE here. It's a spider IDLE. No matter which class you are, which IDLE you are creating, that IDLE should be containing execute. It's called duck typing here. So a bird, like a bird swims like a duck, quacks like a duck, and so that is a duck. No, it's like a class, a spider class, let's say. That's an IDLE that should contain execute method. So if I call IDLE dot execute, it will execute this method. Okay, that's a duck typing. You know, I can also create one more IDLE. Say and this ideally should be pi chart. And this pi chart will do onto I'm going to create an object for spider ideally. So let's say ideally is equal to spider, and also sorry, first we will create an object for this ideally. Ideally, and after that we will create an object for spider. So now I'm going to pass this spider object to this run method inside the ideally class. So it will execute this method. Okay. I'm also creating another class PyCharm. If I run ideally dot run spider, so it will run the spider method. So it is compiling and running. So if I pass this PyCharm object, it will also execute, but something it will work on auto finishing. Like that, you have many ideallys, but the ideally should contains execute method. Okay, so that's the typing. Let's see another method overloading. So method overloading means when you have a method in a class that takes one parameter, so I'm going to assign define another method that contains one parameter. That like in other languages we have method overloading, but in Python we don't have. I will just explain what is the method overloading means. So let's say we have a class here. In that class I'm having a function takes no parameters. Let's say, and if I have another class, another method, that the same name but different parameters. Let's say I'm having another. First parameter should be self here. So you can define another method that takes one parameter. It takes no parameter.
Irfan, sorry to interrupt you. Why we are using self there?
Self is an object. No, if you create an object for a class, let's say obj equal to sample. So this method is called a non-static method. Okay, in Python defaultly all the method is non-static method. If you don't give that, it will give you an error. So if you call that obj dot sample here, yeah, just obj dot run here. Yeah. So I'll just remove this. So this object will go to the self object. We can also call this function like different method, like sample class name dot here and the method, and here we need to pass the object. why we need the object. So this is an object. So object will go to the self keyword. Okay, self parameter. Let's say why we need the object is because whenever you want to work with the self, let's say object in inside the method. Okay, whenever you want to work with the object inside this method, you will use this self. Let's say I'm creating a variable, let's say a equal to 10. So it will create an instance variable. So for this object, it will create a variable. So how you can create inside the method? Wherever you can create a instance variable on the, or else we can also call the function. Like if I'm having a function here, let's say, so this will be having self, okay?
Okay.
It says like hi. I want to call this method inside this method. How you call? Using the method only, now we will call this function. So this is a method, okay? Sorry, it's an object. Using this object, you can call dot sample. Inside this method also, you can call another method. That's why we are using self. Self is a current working object. That is a current working object. Remember that. So if I create another object, object 2 here. So if I call run here, the object 2 will go to the self only. The object will not go to the self. Okay. I hope you understand that.
Yeah. Thanks.
I think that is an object, let's say. It's an object only.
Okay. Yeah.
So we'll continue. So the method. The same name. So run method. So but I'm having another keyword here. So this will not work in Python. I will just tell you how this working. Dot is equal. So you can see here it is giving me an error. So says redefinition of unused run from line 5. So like we have defined run previously, so we cannot define another function the same name. That's why it's giving me error. In other languages it will work. So you can take one parameter. If you give here a parameter, it will go to this function only. If you don't give the parameter, it will go to the this function. So that is the method overloading. So I hope you understand. So let's go to the next. So you will see method overriding here. So let's say have a class here. Let's say sample. We have done a method overriding before. I will show you how. So here we are done method overriding is because you are creating a method the same name inside another class that will become a method overriding. Okay. Say to take this sample. Same example here. In A, it says in A. Okay. I'm creating another class that inherits class A. B inherits A. Okay. Inside this class, I'm going to redefine the sample. Okay. Def. The same name, it will not give error. It's because it's not you are redefining the same class. you are defining another class, so that will not give you an error. Okay. So it says in B. So which will call this function or this function? So if I create class B object, this only will call. Why is because whenever you call a function using the class B object, first it will search in the class B only. After that only it will go to the class A. Okay. So it found the search in the class B. So it's found the sample method. So it will execute this sprint in B. Okay. So now I'm going to call sample here. You can see only one method is available. So first it will search in this class. So it has the sample method. So it will call this method. Okay. Sorry. Why is because we don't have specified the self keyword. So we need to give the parameter. So in B, it says in B, we create a class for object A. It will search in that class A, so it will give you print in A. Okay, it is a method overriding. You are redefining a method that exists in the class A, so you are just updating the method. Let's say it is an method overriding. So it's used in application developments. So if you want to develop something, you will redefine a class and do whatever you want in here. This method overriding, and another one, it is very useful one, operator overloading, very useful. You understand the operator overloading, you will understand everything to what is going on this Python. Okay, let's create my own class. Let's say for example a equal to 10 and b equal to 25. Okay, we print a plus b, what it will give? It will give only 35. No, so what is happening inside that you will see here. So before I said, you are not assigning 10 value to A, you are just creating an object of integer. Okay, it's a type of integer. Inside you are just creating an object. So A is an object of integer and B is an object of integer. Okay, whenever you say object 1, object A plus object B, inside that, so class A, let's say it's a class A and belongs to integer class. In that class contains a method, special method that is called add here. Let's say this add function, what it does, it will take two objects, let's say this object and this object. It will add those values or object values, and it will return to the whenever you are calling. Okay, you are also do that, can also do that. Let's say I am creating my own integer class. Let's say integer, my own integer, that is, okay. In that inside integer, we have a constructor here. In this constructor, I will take a parameter that is a value. Let's say value. So this the value you are passing. And I will store the value to the instance variable, the value equal to value. So now it becomes instance variable. Every object that is different. So now I'm going to define that add method here. Add, and it takes two parameters. One is self and another one is other object. self is the first object and other is the next B object, let's say. And I'm going to add those values. Let's say my integer class give you like this. Okay. So I will return it, not to print, just return this. Why we are returning is because the print function is calling that method no. So it is returning the value to the print function. So what we are going to return, first you are going to return self dot value, and let's say, and I'm going to make that str string. So it looks pretty much str, and I'm going to give plus. So this string concatenation only. What I want, the result like this: 10 plus 20 equal to 30. Like this, I want. I will return like this. So I'm just creating str. I'm just converting the integer to str, and this I'm adding plus sign and the other value. So str of other dot value. And the last we want equal to sign plus equal to sign, and one more we have the result. So we need to add those values, str of self dot value. And plus other dot value. So it's like this. So instead of self dot value is the value of A, let's say 10, and the plus sign here. So I'm just adding the plus sign, and instead of other value is like the B value, let's say 20. And after that, I'm adding equal to sign here. So I'm just adding the equal to sign. And after that, the result will come. For result, I'm adding those values. So self dot value and other dot value. So the value is nothing but just we are created in the instant variable. Okay. Now I'm going to create an object of my class, my integer class. Say A equal to integer class, and inside this I'm going to pass a value, let's say 10, and I'm going to create B, and I'm going to pass this 20. So if I print A plus B, so the result will look like this. See what we want now. So in, if you say A plus B, the plus is nothing but the add method. Inside that is calling the special method that is called add method. Like add, we have a sub method. Sub method is called subtraction. Let's say I'm going to have underscore sub. This also will take two parameters, one is self and the other one is other, let's say. So I'm going to print here. A minus B. So the minus, it's a subtraction. So it will call this method. Let's return the result. The result is like self dot value minus other dot value. So if I run this, so it will give you 10 minus 20 minus 10. Yeah. So now it is my class, so integer class, it belongs to this class. If I say minus, we'll call the sub method. inside the sub method, it takes two parameter. One is A and let's say other one is B. A and B. So I'm just subtracting those values. Inside that, self dot value minus other dot value. We will return the value. So the value is returning, that is -10. Okay. So I hope you understand. And the other also we have like a multiplication. For multiplication, we have a method called __ mul. Okay, mul is for multiplication. Other it also takes two parameters like that. Every arithmetical operators will takes two parameters only. So I'm going to return self dot value multiplied by other dot value. Okay, if I run this, so it will give me 10 × 20 = 200. So it's giving me 200. So if I say A star B, it will call the method called __ mul inside this integer class. So it takes self and two parameters. One is self and other one is other. For divide also we have __ __ div is for division. Wherever you where you find this method names, you can find one thing in the integer class. So it's available for in Python. So it is, if it's written in Python, you can just put dot here and you can find the add init mul sub. Okay, it's all inside the class integer. So the class belongs to the in Python class we have. So you can see here, this is a class of integer in Python. So you can see here, all these are special method. ABC absolute, add is for adding, and AND operation. You see AND operation. We will take two conditions. In that two conditions, we will true or false. We will give you like that. Okay, boolean, seal. Seal is nothing but the like if you say 5.7, it will give you 6 like that. And so like we have so many, and this is useful greater than. So if you are comparing those values, let's say we will define that method inside our class. What if so gt greater than, we'll compare those values. Okay, sorry, other, let's say it will compare those values and return that. Greater than means it will check whether the self dot value is greater than the other dot value. If I say A greater than B, sorry, the greater than operator will call the GT method inside the class. So it will give me true or false. 10 is greater than 20. No, that will give me false. It is how you can create your own class using the inbuilt methods, special method. You can also create a sequence also. Okay, I hope you understand this all operator overloading. This is operator overloading. We are just creating the operator method. So wherever you call this plus sign, you will call the add method inside this class. Okay, this any doubts you can ask here. One more thing I will teach you, like we will see the what, why, how the for loop is working. Okay, for loop, let's say that is iterator for loop in Python. So let's see that. So that is very useful to you. So let's say I'm having an str here. What does the for loop will do? For loop will iterate through the str for ch in str one. So it will fetch them one by one characters inside the string. So string is a sequential data type in Python. So it will take one by one characters here. So if I print that, we'll see one by one characters. So m o h j m m d like that. So how you can create a sequence? How this for loop is working? Okay. Inside that, they are just creating a iterator object. So we will see that iterate. What is iterator object means? So let's see how it's working. Let's remove this. I will create this in my program. Let's say I'm going to create an object of iterator. Let's say IT. To create an iterator object, we need to call a function called iter. In that iter, we need to give the iterable object, that is str1, let's say str1 here. So it's created the iterator object. If I print here, how you will get this value? Using that next, you can get the value using the next function here. So next function will give you the next value of the iterator. So let's say if I give the next IT, it will give me M. So I say one more time. Let's make this and make this short. And if I run this, it will give me two values. One is H and E. You can see here. If I print it for 5 times, it will give me whole string. Okay, hello, it's given. If I call one more time, it will give me error. So this is how this for loop is handling those iterable objects. So stop iteration is give me. So it's because if you say the for loop, it will create first, it will create an iterator object. It will create it will just call the next value, next value, next value until we get the stop iteration error. Okay, if you get stop iteration error, it will exit from the for loop. So we can create the for loop using the while loop also. Let's say I'm having this while true will run infinitely whenever we will not break the loop. So I'm going to give a try block, is because you call this next value, in the last we will get stop iteration. Okay, now inside this I'm going to, first I will create an iterator object for this. And inside this try block, I'm going to call next of that, next IT. Okay, next iterator object. So infinitely it will call whenever you are getting the error called stop iteration, just break the loop. Break. So whatever break does, it will exit from this loop. Okay. So now we'll run that. So you can see here, hello is coming. So not only this iterable object, you can also have a list. Okay, 10 comma 20 comma 30 comma 40 comma 50, let's say. If I run this, you will get 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. So this is how this for loop is working. This is the content of for loop. Okay. So I hope you understand this all things. That that any doubts here inside this all this and the stars. So from this speech I'll end this session. So doubts here you can ask me. So this is operator overloading, it's very helpful for you. You can also create your own classes, own data types also. Okay.
Irfan, can you explain method overloading once quickly?
Method overloading, okay. So let's say method overloading. Method overloading in a sense, you have a method inside the class, the same name we have method, but different parameters.
It's a
method overloading. So in Python, we don't have the method overloading. So that's why it's getting an error. So redefinition of unused run, okay? You can also define one more method also. In other languages, it will work, but in Python, it will not work. You can also have another parameter also. So how you use these methods? If you call the method without parameter, without argument, so it will call this function, okay? If you give one parameter, one argument, it will call this method.
Okay.
If you give two parameters, it will call this function.
Okay, based on the parameters what I am passing, appropriate method will call.
Yes, yes.
Okay. This is called method overloading.
Yeah.
Okay. Please go on mute. Like I could hear some background noise.
So any doubts?
Any doubts you have? Okay. Irfan, you can continue or else.
Yeah, it's completed.
Okay. So tomorrow, what would be the topic, Irfan?
Yeah, Django only. So introduction to Django and basic.
Okay, today we have completed inheritance and polymorphism. Am I right?
Yeah.
Okay. So tomorrow we'll have Django, and that is the Django framework, and it's a basic introduction of Django would be there. So you can attend the session. So today, this videos, no, you will see that as I instructed before. You can see that in this place. Irfan, can I unshare your screen?
Yeah.
Okay. So you can. You can see in our website, bigdatahandson.com. And you can, at your homepage itself now, you can see the videos. In this bigdatahandson.com/videos, you know, like if you are clicking this meetup uploads, meetup videos, then you will be ending up in this page. And here, no, you can see all those parts. Videos, no, you can see it in this place. So you can just click on that. So part 1, part 2, part 3, part 4, part 5, everything is available. Today is part 6 and tomorrow Django would be part 7. So all will be uploaded inside. So you can have a look. If you want to have any certificates, then you can pay rupees 500 and you can get certificates. If you want to have certificates, there is certificates would be sent online from bigdatahandson.com. If you want to have, but you need to attend all 7 classes. After that, you will be issued a certificate. So if you want certificate, then you can pay it and you can send it. You can have, I'll be sending it to you, to your mail. I'll, any doubts you have, then you can call me at, call us at 978-988-424. So this would be our number. 978-988-424 95661823 84. You can call us anytime as you wish. And Irfan, that's it, right?
Yes.
Irfan?
Yeah.
Yeah, we are done with the questions, right? Okay. Yeah. Thank you. Meet all tomorrow. Thank you.